Hi, how are you? My name is Carrie, and welcome to my channel if you're new. Today, I just wanted to talk about my delusions and kind of go into detail about that. I was diagnosed schizophrenic, bipolar, and a couple of other things back in 2015, committed and told I was delusional. And if you haven't seen my my awakening videos, you're welcome to go and take a look at those. I do go into great detail about what happened and how it happened and everything that took place with that. So yeah, those are on my channel here. I think there's like four of them. So yeah, so briefly, just to give you a little bit of back history, some of the delusions that I had, and I use that word very loosely because I feel like if somebody is experiencing something, that I have a cat just jumped in my lap. Say, hey, Mickey. Hi. I feel like if you're experiencing it, you're seeing it, or you're thinking it, then that's valid. That's you know, not for someone else to say, oh, that's invalid. You're not really seeing what you're seeing. You're not really hearing what you're hearing. You're not thinking that for any reason other than you're crazy and take these pills. That, you know, we don't want people saying that to us because that makes it seem like we're just completely off the rocker, and that's not always the case, you know. So okay, so back to my delusions. I thought that my dog was a dragon. I thought that I was either being told I was a black feline or a feline person, or I was perceiving a black feline person that was communicating with me. And then I also, at a later point in time, the phase two of my awakening, I also thought I was a vampire, which, you know, kind of goes hand in hand with the feline person because they would have fangs and, you know, that sort of thing too. I thought I had visions of me being at the bottom of an ocean, made of stone, and I was just waiting at the bottom of an ocean, and I said, don't let me freeze again, to my friend, because I just saw me just sitting at the bottom of an ocean. Yet I kept asking, when did I die, when, you know. But and I also thought that I was on a ship. I had this this vision of me flying out of the ship, like if I was to go from the den in where I was staying out to the garage, that I would just fly out in the vacuum of space because I was on a ship. So, and these symptoms or these thoughts and visions just kind of happened when I actually had just taken a Bible course online, and I said for the first time in years a prayer and really meant it. And then I was, you know, about, I'd say 3-4 hours later is when this started. And I also thought that animals could talk, that at any point my dog was just gonna look up and start talking to me. Yeah, she would do that. And when I thought she was a dragon, I actually thought that I was underwater and she would just morph into a dragon and I'd be able to ride her up to the top of the water. And she's a little chihuahua. And then the last thing that I'm going to mention here is that it's common for people, from what I know of, as schizophrenia runs in my family, that people will think that someone is someone else like you'll be you'll be talking to somebody, but you'll think that they're really somebody else. And for me, when this first happened, I thought that my daughter was my dog and my dog, and my, I thought that my daughter was my cat, a cat that was over there. Yeah, that got kind of crazy for a minute, so to speak. But yeah, I thought people were other people, and I thought that I was really married and this and that. But okay, so when you have those kinds of thoughts, what are they? What causes that? Is it us that's really delusional, or is it everybody else that is not in tune with what's really going on? Because to me, I and after this happened, I started researching, and here's some of the things that I found, and I'm going to go ahead and show you what I found, because I can prove this stuff to myself, but you know, I of course I can't really prove it to someone else. You know, the truth, actually, Ralph Smart from Infinite Waters says, truth cannot be taught, it has to be realized. So just for example, I'm gonna go ahead and show you what I have found. Okay, so whenever you do a Google search for draconian, this is what you come up with. And if you know anything about the cabal and the dark government, okay, you know that that exists. Okay, so if you look up Draco, yeah, this right here just says Draco Lawgiver. That's kind of interesting. But then there's a draconian band, a video game, draconian on Doctor Who is a television series. Of course, this is a fictional species, and this Dragonlance, I think that's a book or a game. Yeah, okay, so then you go over to the Ascension glossary portion. Honestly, I don't know. Yeah, this is like Wikipedia offshoot, Ascension glossary. So this goes into detail there. Yeah, this stuff isn't in the history books. But the losers of war don't write the history books. So, okay. Yeah, and then you go over here, okay, in the Nibiruan Council. Okay. Now, just bear with me here. Because when you have multiple sources saying the same thing, that's whenever you really need to pay attention. Okay, so this goes into some of the history. This is the true history. And it talks about Carrions, which are bird people, and felines that were in the universe long before humans and reptilians. Okay, and I'll let you go here and do your own research. This would be a reptilian, and a feline being. And then in the background, you see the Carrions, the birds. So, so that, just think, okay, look at this, Carrions, okay? All right, so you might think, oh, well, that's, you know, that doesn't really exist. That's just fiction. But look at this. This is, now I'm not sure how to pronounce it, but paleolexicon.com. And it's basically a study of ancient languages. Okay, it means old dictionary. So you go here to languages, okay, and look at that. The Carrion language. Okay, so even though Carrions are mentioned frequently in ancient literature, most things about them remained a mystery until the 80s, when the Carrion writing was finally deciphered. We knew nothing about their language. Okay, so now it doesn't say here, hey, that's bird people, but I'm just kind of putting two and two together. Now, as far as me, you know, thinking I was made of stone, now this gets interesting for me, because they found these statues underwater. This is the city of Thonis, and I'm probably butchering it, Heraklion. Heraclean. Now, this is a mixture of different words here, or the different people. This is probably Herod and Cleopatra. So it's something to do with that, and probably Thoth as well, the T-H-O. So I haven't researched that exactly, that city. I'm just kind of trying to get my point across here. But look what they're finding underwater. Natural disasters, yeah, I don't think so. Statues, huge statues of a pharaoh. Now I come down here. Now I did have a delusion of my head being pulled up from the water. Now this was before I even knew about this, and I saw this happening, and I don't know how. I was just it was in my head, and I don't know why, a giant head being pulled up from water. And then this is just a Google search, image search of what I found of ancient statues in the ocean. Now look at this. This is a human head on a cat body, a feline body. So you're welcome to go and do your own research there. But they're finding these statues made out of stone, some kind of stone, and sitting under the ocean. Okay, now as far as this being a ship, the earth being a ship, I can't tell you what it is. I can only tell myself what I believe and put that information out there. But listen to this. This is thisspaceshipearth.org. This spaceship Earth is the name for the state of the planet as it exists today. And it says, no matter what country, state, or province you live in, you are part of the one planet we all share, and we have no other spaceship. All we have and all humanity has is this spaceship Earth. Okay? And then you go over here. They hide information in plain sight. So Team Dark or Team Light cannot make moves against each other or on each other without telling the other what's really going on. If you know anything about the galactic game of polarity integration. But this is Florence and the Machine, Ship to Wreck. I'm sure you've heard it. Did I build this ship to wreck? Well, what's she talking about there? And then you go down here, she says, good God, under starless skies we are lost. Into the breach we got tossed, and the water's coming in fast. And she's talking about, did I build this ship to wreck? Over here, I went to YouTube. I did a spaceship Earth search. And this is, you know, they're just basically waving it in our face, saying, hey, you're on a ship, y'all. I've had various dreams about it as well. Here is somebody I found. I'm subscribed to him. MC Xander does a song called Spaceship Earth. Okay, and then one other thing real quick, and I'll get off of my soapbox here. the thing where people think that they're somebody else. That's not a delusion. And then I'm going to post links to all of this stuff so you can come in and look. But this is Soul Group, and it's a representation of Soul Group compared to you and Source and all of that. So here's Source up here. This is our higher self, and we're connected to all of this. Well, our higher self remembers everything, and here's us down here. We are extensions of Soul, okay? And now there, I'm sure you know about parallel, you've heard of parallel universes and things like that, parallel realities. Well, you know, this isn't for play. It's a game, but it's not a game. I mean, it's a divine game. It's serious, you know, this is people's lives. But yeah, don't you think that these people have been other people at certain points? Our souls, I mean, I don't know if you are religious, if you're watching this, but yeah, our souls have been around the block a few times. So Yeah, that's all I have to say about that. Those were my delusions that I wanted to mention today. I don't want this video getting too long, but I was able to go and research through and find that I'm not delusional. I'm not sick. And if you're watching this, you're probably not either. So thank you so much for tuning in. And if you have anything to say, please leave a comment, or you're welcome to email me. My name is Carrie, and I hope you have a good day. Bye.